We seem to be talking about political correctness a lot. Just yesterday, this article appeared in Queensland's Courier Mail about the mistake baby of world sporting events, the Commonwealth Games.
Forget g'day. Volunteers are being told to welcome visitors with the little-known Aboriginal greeting, Jingari.
My God. You can't even say g'day anymore. And on the Gold Coast of all places, the home of all things Australian, Margot Robbie, the beaches, mate. Chip.
How you going?
In case you needed any insight into what this new decree really is, read the next line. It's
the latest political correctness controversy to hit the event.
The article goes on to give previous examples of political correctness, such as staff being invited to an Invasion Day barbecue and volunteers being told to use gender-neutral language. Then, of course, comes the obligatory comment from person who thinks political correctness has gone mad. Or in this case, it's Queensland LNP Polly John Paul Langbroke.
It's completely proper to acknowledge our Indigenous culture and heritage, but to ram it down the throats of visiting spectators with a strange mandated greeting is just another case of PC absurdity.
Ram it down throats, mandated greeting, PC absurdity? Between the ram and the PC, you'd think John was talking about something other than the evidently autocratic dystopia that is the Gold Coast. It's only if you make it through to the second last paragraph of the article that you see this.
There is no compulsion to use any language or narrative. However, the training manual offers suggestions as a guide only.
A guide, you say? You mean you can still say g'day? But if you wanted to say something else, something that was perhaps unique and pertinent to the time and the place, you could? Yeah, that doesn't sound hugely PC gone mad to me, but hello, I work for the PC Brigade. Everything is problematic here. It is so exhausting. Now, you're probably thinking, what is your point, Jan? Huh? Well, I just found this article to be very indicative of the way that we talk about language and political correctness. That's all. You know, there's always this idea that we can't say anything anymore. And then when you just unpack it a little, actually, you can say things. But somehow the headline, Local Aboriginal Greeting Jingari, another way to say hello at Commonwealth Games if you want to, yeah, doesn't quite have the same ring to it. But here is where I sever the lefty umbilical cord that attaches me to this low-paying organisation. Because actually, questions around language are warranted, particularly at a time when we're talking about subjective identity more and more. Like, who gets to decide? And more importantly, who gets to enforce the type of language that we use and how we use it? Right now, at the Commonwealth Games, no one is enforcing anything, so just, be cool. Around issues of political correctness, be alert, not alarmed. Unless you're reading a News Corp paper, in which case it is really impossible not to be alarmed.